Hey everyone! In last month's video, we discovered the Flipper Zero added support for the em4305. In this video, we'll use the Flipper Zero to program an em4305, allowing you to create a physical card instead of having to use the Flipper Zero to emulate a card. We'll also take a look at which protocols are supported by the em4305. And how to apply a pull request I created to add even more protocols. Let's get started. One of the confusing things about RFID is many tags look similar and the same chip can come in a variety of shapes. Here I'm using a flashlight so we can see the insides of a T5577 RFID tag. And there's the chip next to the coil. And then when I switch to the em4305, we can see that there's the coil and there's a chip. And I don't think you can rely on the color to identify the chip. Here's a table of the various low frequency RFID protocols supported by the Flipper Zero. And you can write all of these protocols to a T5577 card. The em4305 can only use Manchester encoding, which is this column, or it can use diphase encoding, which is this column. Currently, the support for writing to em4305 is only for the em4100 protocol, Electra, Viking, and Gallagher. Later in the video, we'll look at how to modify your firmware to be able to write some of these other protocols. There are actually three versions of the em4305 with different resident capacitors. A lot of times these capacitors aren't specified, but you want the 330 if you're going to be using RF40. And again, we saw earlier that RF40 is used for that Securakey protocol. The em4305 datasheet looks fairly typical. But one interesting configuration is bit 26 for pigeon mode. If you're a pigeon race security tester, the Flipper Zero currently doesn't support pigeon mode. But leave a comment and reach out to me on Discord if you need me to create an application that would enable pigeon mode. On my Flipper Zero, we'll go into the 125 kilohertz RFID and say read, and then we'll put it on a blank em4305. So when you first get a card, it may be blank, and when that happens, there's nothing for the flipper to read. This manufacturer programmed the card with a hex value of all ones, and when we read the other card, it's also a hex value of all ones. So this proves that the card can emulate the em4100, but the data for each card is identical. Now let's go ahead and load up a saved em4100 card I have, and this one is hex 845 FED. And then we'll go back to write, and what's going to happen is it's going to write the data to the T5577, write the data to the em4305, and then read. And if the read is successful, like it just was, now when we go into read, it should read our card, and there it is. And the hex is 845 FED. Or if you prefer, you can sing the DES8 number. We'll go back into saved. And this time we'll try writing with the FDX-B protocol, which uses my pull request changes to add support. And there it is, success. And then we can go to read. And you can see the animals tag with their country and ID. And since we're just emulating an FDX-B pet tag, I don't recommend setting the temperature because we don't want people thinking that's the temperature of the pet. Here's another quick demo where I've connected my flipper to that debug console. And we'll go ahead and do an em4100 and say write. And on the screen behind, you can see it did a data write, which is to the T5577 and the EM4305. And then it starts ASK and does a read started and read stopped, scanning for the correct data on the tag. In our firmware repo, we'll go into lib, and then LF RFID, and then protocols. So we're searching for in this directory. So go ahead and click on search in this directory. And then we'll add the EM4305 is what we're looking for. You could also do this to look for the T5577 if you'd like. And here you can see the EM4100 is a supported protocol, and there's the code that it's using to set the configuration and data. And Electra is a supported protocol, and there's the code. And Gallagher, there's the code, and Viking. So those are the supported protocols for the EM4305 currently in this firmware. Next, I'll show how you can add additional protocols to the Momentum firmware. Go into pull requests and search for EM4305. So as I'm making this video, you can see that there's one open and zero closed. That means that the fix has not been checked into Momentum firmware yet. It just supports those four protocols. But if it does say closed, then I recommend you go to momentum-fw.dev, click install, and then choose the dev branch and say flash. And this will update your flipper to the latest dev branch, which if closed, it probably has support for this change. However, if it still says open, go ahead and click on the title and then make sure that you've installed the get tools from get-scm and then also the GitHub CLI tools. And then once you've done both of those, you'll go to code and then the green code button and copy URL to clipboard, open a command prompt, and then we'll do a get clone --- recursive and paste in the link to Momentum firmware. And then I'm going to add MNTM just as a folder. And then under pull requests, again, we're going to want that EM4305. Go ahead and go into that. And then over on the right, you should see a code. Go ahead and click on that. And then copy this GitHub PR checkout 434. There's the copied. So now that's on the clipboard. And cloning this repo takes a while, so I'm probably just going to jump ahead here. And now we're just about done cloning. There we are. And now we can go ahead and paste in that GitHub PR checkout 434 command. Oh, I forgot. First, we have to do a CD into the Momentum folder that we just created, and then we can do our GitHub PR checkout 434. So that command has changed which branch we're working on. If we do a get status, you'll see we're now in Jameson Derrick /EM4305 instead of the dev branch. This next step is optional, but I always do it, which is FBT and then VS code _dist. And this just sets up all of the toolchain so that Visual Studio Code can be used for development and deployment to your Flipper Zero. Again, this takes a while, so I'll go ahead and jump ahead in the video. And now you can either open Visual Studio Code and deploy to your Flipper that way, or if you want, you can just use another FBT command with FBT force =1. And then flash _USB_full. And this will build the firmware and then it will deploy it to your Flipper Zero. So make sure your Flipper Zero is plugged in and that QFlipper and lab.flipper.net are not running. I'll go ahead and jump forward in this video. And about 8 minutes later for me, I see that the Momentum firmware was updated. And it now has support for Electra, Securakey, Jablotron, and FDX-B. Securakey uses that RF divided by 40 data rate, which requires the 330 picofarad capacitor in your em4305. So if it's not writing, it's possible that you don't have the proper hardware. Also, for some of these cards, they have a hard time actually doing that data rate. So you may have to move the flipper around a little bit on the card to find a good angle at which the data will read. So here you can see I'm trying different angles, and it's writing and then reading, writing and reading, and it successfully read. So now we can go ahead and awkwardly go back and read the card. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them below or contact me on Discord.